In the UK, you're not really allowed to provide financial services unless you're authorised or exempt. The practical effect of this is that you may have to apply to the FCA for authorisation, get permissions in respect of various regulated activities. This can have a direct impact on your business plan in terms of the cost of the application fee, potentially regulatory capital, how long things are going to take. Otherwise, you can potentially be exempt, and how we see fintechs do that in practice is that they go through the appointed representative regime and operate under the umbrella of a authorised entity. And there's a third way, which is to just identify the part of your business which is a regulated activity and contract with a third-party provider for them to do that, so that you can focus on something else which is adding value to your potential clients. It's something that needs to be taken really seriously, because to breach the general prohibition is a criminal offence, and contracts which are entered into in an authorised business are potentially unenforceable. If you are concerned and think that you might be carrying out business which needs to be authorised or potentially authorised, take a look at the Perimeters Guiders Manual, which is the manual by the FCA in their handbook, which gives you their interpretation of their rules and whether or not you need to be authorised. It's an obvious place to start, and you can also get in touch with them at the Innovation Hub, have a conversation, and we're also available to have that chat as well.